हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डीजी वैरम। वेलकम बैक इन दिस लेक्चर। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द रिलेशन बिटवीन डेल्टा जी एंड डेल्टा जी नॉट। देन वी हैव सीन द रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ इक्विलिब्रिया टू कंडीशंस एंड प्रॉब्लम्स। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी द इक्विलिब्रियम कॉन्स्टेंट एंड एक्सटेंट ऑफ रिएक्शन एंड ऑल्सो इफेक्ट ऑफ कैटलिस्ट। सो लेट स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट टॉपिक, इक्विलिब्रियम कॉन्स्टेंट एंड एक्सटेंट ऑफ रिएक्शन। यू नो दैट द गिब्स फ्री एनर्जी ऑफ एनी रिएक्शन मिक्सचर डिपेंड्स अपॉन द इट्स पार्शियल प्रेशर एज वेल एज इट्स कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स एंड द प्रोडक्ट्स। सो देयर फॉर द टेंडेंसी ऑफ रिएक्शन टू गो इन द फॉरवर्ड और द रिवर्स डिरेक्शन इज डिटर्मन बाय द पार्शियल प्रेशर और इट्स कॉन्सेंट्रेशन। सो द डेल्टा जी चेंजेस ड्यूरिंग द रिएक्शन एज द प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स एंड प्रोडक्ट चेंजेस। सो द कंपोजिशन ऑफ रिएक्शन मिक्सचर एट इक्विलिब्रियम इज द कंपोजिशन एट विच चेंज इन गिब्स एनर्जी इज इक्वल टू जीरो। लुक एट दिस फिगर। इफ the value of k is greater than 1, in such a case the product concentration, here look at here, the product concentration is much greater than the reactant concentration. Okay, when if the k value is greater than 1, in such a case the product concentration, this product concentration is greater than the reactant concentration at a equilibrium. At a equilibrium, most of the reactant are converted into the products here. Such type of reaction is product favor. On the other hand, look at this figure. If k value is less than 1, the equilibrium is established when most of the reactant remains unreacted. So such reaction is a reactant favor. So this is the actual figure. When k value is less than 1, in such a case the equilibrium is established when the reactants remain unreacted. So this is the reactant favor. Now look at the last figure. When k value is equal to 1, in such a case both reactants and products present in substantial amount at equilibrium. So next topic is went out equation. Basically the relation between delta G naught, the standard Gibbs free energy change, and Kp is given by this equation. So standard Gibbs free energy change is equal to minus RT ln Kp. So this equation we can rearrange and write as, we can write as ln Kp is equal to minus delta G naught upon RT. You know that the delta G naught is equal to delta H naught plus T delta S naught. Okay, so by considering this equation we can write this equation as minus delta H naught upon RT plus minus T delta S naught upon RT. Okay, now here TT gets cancelled, so we'll get minus delta H naught upon RT plus minus delta S naught upon R. So this is the equation number 1. Now here assume that delta S naught and delta S naught are independent of temperature. So equation 1 we can write at 2 temperature such as ln Kp 1 is equal to minus delta H naught upon RT 1 plus delta S naught upon R. Consider the equation number 1. Next, ln Kp2 is equal to minus delta H naught upon RT2 plus delta S naught upon R. So this is the equation number 3. Now subtracting equation 2 from equation 3, we'll get such type of equation: ln Kp2 minus ln Kp1 is equal to minus delta H naught upon R into 1 upon T2 minus 1 upon T1. Here minus delta H naught upon R is taking minus delta H naught upon R is constant, so we'll get this equation. Now ln Kp2 minus ln Kp1 is equal to delta H naught upon R into 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. Okay, just rearranging this equation for this equation, we'll get second equation, this one. So the previous equation is one form of one top equation. So by using the one top equation, we can calculate the equilibrium constant at another temperature. Suppose if the reaction is endothermic, you know, endothermic means delta H naught is positive and T2 is greater than T1, that is T1 minus T2 is negative. In such a case, ln Kp1 by Kp2 is negative, therefore Kp2 greater than Kp1. On the other hand, an increase in temperature favors the formation of products if the reaction is endothermic. And for exothermic reaction, the result will be reverse. Now, we have to see the problems based on this concept. So, first problem is the equilibrium constant for the synthesis of ammonia. So this is the given reaction, that means the synthesis of ammonia when N2 gas combined with S2 gas to form ammonia. Here 6.8 into 10 to the 5 at 298 Kelvin. Now we have to predict its value at 400 degree Kelvin and delta H naught F for ammonia molecule is already given, that is the minus 46.11 kilojoule per mole. So let us see its solution. So first of all, we have to calculate delta H naught. So delta H naught here 2 into delta H naught F into ammonia, that means 2 indicate the number of moles, into the standard enthalpy of formation of ammonia minus standard enthalpy of formation of N2 minus 3 means number of moles, into standard enthalpy of formation of H2. Then 2 into the standard enthalpy of formation of ammonia molecule is 46 minus 46.11, and the standard enthalpy of formation for any element is equal to 0. So we can write as 0 here, and minus 3 into, and similarly for H2 is also 0. So we'll get delta H naught value is minus 92.22 kilojoule. Now ln Kp2 upon ln Kp1 is equal to delta H naught upon R into 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. So this is the one form of one top equation. So by using this equation, we can calculate the value at 400 Kelvin. So delta H naught value is minus 92.22 upon R value is 8.314 into 10 raised to minus 3, and the initial temperature is 298 and the final temperature is 400 Kelvin. So by solving this, so we'll get 9.49. okay, so here ln Kp2, the ln Kp1 value is 6.8 into 10 raised to 5. Then ln Kp2 is equal to ln 6.8 into 10 raised to 5 minus 9.49. Just rearranging this equation, ln Kp2 is equal to 3.9398. So this is the value of ln Kp2. So finally, we'll get the Kp2 value is equal to 51.49. This is the value at 400 Kelvin. So next topic is effect of catalyst. Students, we know that what is meant by catalyst? Catalyst is a substance which alters the rate of reaction, but it does not take part in the reaction. Just it increase or it speed up the reaction. Okay, so a catalyst has no effect on the equilibrium composition of a reaction mixture. So for this type of effect of catalyst, so we have to see the problem. So first problem is, arsenic can be extracted from its ore by first reacting the ore with oxygen to form solid tetraarsenic hexoxide, which is then reduced using carbon. So this is the given reaction. So we have to predict the direction of equilibrium position in response to each of the following changes in direction. So first of all, when we add carbon monoxide, we have to see what will happen. Second, addition or removal of carbon or tetraarsenic hexoxide, and last, when we remove gases, arsenic, here gases, arsenic, so what will happen? Let us see. First, when carbon monoxide, first of all, see this reaction. When we add the carbon monoxide, so this concept basically explained very well on the basis of reaction quotient. We know that when the carbon monoxide is added, what will happen? The numerator value will increase by the addition of carbon monoxide. As the numerator value increases, ultimately the reaction quotient, that means the Q value, increases. And you know that when Q is greater than K, this one, when Q is greater than K, in such a case, the equilibrium of the reaction will shift towards left. That means the backward reaction will favor. Now, the addition or removal of carbon or tetraarsenic hexoxide, in such a case, the amount of pure solid has no effect on the equilibrium position. Changing the amount of कार्बन और टेट्रा आर्सेनिक हेक्साऑक्साइड. सो इन दिस केस द रिमूवल और एडिशन ऑफ कार्बन और टेट्रा आर्सेनिक हेक्साऑक्साइड विल हैव नो इफेक्ट. एंड द लास्ट वन बाय द रिमूवल ऑफ गैसियस आर्सेनिक व्हेन ओके सपोज दिस इज द रिएक्शन व्हेन we remove the gaseous arsenic. When we remove the gaseous arsenic, so what will happen? If the gaseous arsenic is removed, then Q will decrease. Of course, by the removal of arsenic, gaseous arsenic, the numerator value will decrease. As the numerator value decrease, the Q value also decrease. So we can say that the Q value is less than K. So in such a case, the equilibrium of the reaction will shift towards right. That means the forward reaction will favored. Okay. Next problem. Commercial production of hydrogen is governed by the following reaction. So this is the reaction: carbon monoxide react with H2O to form H2 plus carbon dioxide. So here in this reaction delta H is negative. So how will this system at equilibrium shift in each of the following cases? So first of all, gaseous CO2 is removed, then water vapor is added, then in a reaction container the pressure is increased by adding helium gas. Next, the temperature is increased. Last one, the pressure is increased by decreasing the volume of the reaction contents. Okay, so let us see what will happen. So first one, when CO2 is removed, right? When we remove CO2, similarly here also, as the numerator value decrease, the Q value will decrease. And you know that the Q value is decreased, that means the Q is less than K. In such a case, the forward reaction will favor. So this can be explained on the basis of reaction quotient. Second, where water vapor is added. Water vapor is added. So what will happen? The water vapor added means the denominator value will increase. See this reaction here. We know that the equilibrium constant is the product divided by reactants. When water vapor is added, the denominator value increases. As the denominator value increases, the Q value decreases. So when Q is less than K, in such a case, the forward reaction will favor. Next, helium, you know, helium is an inert gas. If the pressure is increased, the equilibria will not be affected. Why? Because number of moles of reactant is equal to the number of moles of products. So there will be no effect of the pressure on helium. Next, if we increase the temperature, the reaction will move towards left as the reaction is exothermic. Of course, as we increase the temperature, the reaction will shift toward the left side as the reaction is exothermic, because the reaction is exothermic. Last one, if the pressure is increased by decreasing the volume, as we increase the pressure, the volume will decrease. Therefore, the change in moles is equal to zero. So there will be no any changes by increasing the प्रेशर, ओके। अब स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द वन टॉप इक्वेशन, देन वी हैव सीन द इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट एंड एक्सटेंट ऑफ रिएक्शन, एंड द लास्ट वी हैव सीन इफेक्ट ऑफ कैटलिस्ट। And in the next lecture, we will see the salt hydrolysis. Okay, thank you.